group's heading to the tiny homeland community of Bowaka, one of the most remote places in Australia. For all of them, it's a long way from home.
It's remarkable how foreign this country feels, to like this area that we're in now.
I didn't even know this place existed, to be honest, until today.
It's like going to a country within your country.
The Yolngu people have a connection to this place that dates back at least 50,000 years. But the notion of Aboriginal people being custodians of the land is not something that resonates with Nikki.
I'm not bothered by the idea that it belongs to Aboriginal people because I don't really feel it. Sorry, but I don't. I feel it belongs to everyone who's here.
For Nikki and the rest of the group, the question of who owns the land and what this means is about to be turned on its head.
You can come with us.
Thank you.
Thanks.
This is the ancestral home of traditional owner and elder Timi Jawa Buruwanga. He and his family regularly return here.
Ladies and gentlemen, this place is given by the ancestors. Everything here is yours, even the waters, even the trees, sand. I want you to feel that when I see you. I don't see your color. I have never seen a different colors. This land here today is your land. I'm giving you this land until you go. Please keep it.
As part of their welcome, the six are invited to be painted with red ochre. Ochre is considered sacred and believed to have spiritual powers. For Nikki, the experience is beginning to have an impact.
Sharing the land, saying it's, we're equal, it's your land, it's our land, it was just beautiful. My eyes are opening to all of this, and I'm starting to see it very differently every day.